These are the top three things you need to know about the FOLR1 gene mutation and speech. What does the FOLR1 gene do? Good question. This gene provides instructions for making a protein called the folate receptor alpha. This protein helps regulate the transport of the B vitamin folate into cells. If you don't have this transporter, think of it as like a bus. If you don't have this bus, it's very hard to get folate into the brain. Speech is typically difficult when this happens. What does the FOLR1 gene mutation present as? What does this look like? Late onset seizures that are difficult to control with medication. There's also motor control difficulties, including speech, difficulties, and unexplained global developmental delays. In the brain, folate is needed for making chemical messengers called neurotransmitters and a fatty substance called myelin, which insulates nerve fibers and promotes the rapid transmission of nerve impulses. We want those impulses to go from one nerve to another so that you can do things like move and speak. If your child with autism has seizures, it's typically recommended to do an epilepsy genetic panel. There are hundreds of genes that will be tested, and the FOLR1 is typically included in that epilepsy panel. Insurance in the US many times pays for this kind of medical test. And don't be scared about this gene mutation. Doctors typically give high levels of folate, such as leucovorin, to overcome the lack of the protein made by that gene. This is personalized medicine at its best. So much can change with folate, 5-MTHF, or leucovorin. Hi, I'm Dr. Teresa Lyons. I teach parents the cutting-edge science of autism so that you can make the best decision for your child based on quality information. Please share this video with anyone who has a child with speech issues and autism. They need to know this information.